Welcome to the Financial Freedom Podcast with your host, Lorna Poole, sharing the secrets to creating wealth, investing, and that all-important money mindset. To find out more and accelerate your journey to financial freedom, head on over to www.lornapoole.com to get started. Welcome, everybody. Welcome to the Financial Freedom Podcast. Wouldn't you love, as a student, we build up a lot of debt, and it can cost us for a long time as we get going, get on our feet, figure out what we want to do with our lives, and it can be a real burden on building your financial freedom. Well, my guest expert today is Jean O'Toole, and she's going to share with you ways to reduce college costs for families beyond financial aid and scholarship. She is a scholarship strategist whose seminars and school assemblies have empowered thousands of students to take proactive role to finding outside scholarship for college. Her book, Scholarship Strategies, Finding and Winning the Money You Need, is based on successful strategies. Students have won thousands of dollars applying her approach to the process, as it's her goal to help families across the country achieve their college dreams without the burden of college debt. Jean, great to have you here.
Lorna, it is so wonderful to join you.
You know, as somebody who teaches financial freedom, debt is a huge part of it not happening. And for students, you know, I can't remember the stats. You probably know, Jean. But it's such a burden on your money.
Yeah, right now, as a matter of fact, you know, here in the United States, you know, Forbes has actually put out the most recent stat that we have $1.56 trillion of college debt in the United States.
Wow.
And that is debt that is accrued by over 44 million borrowers. And as a expert yourself in helping people find their financial freedom, I mean, obviously with this debt crisis, it is impacting everything in our society, right? Because of college debt, you know, people are not able to purchase homes in the time that they want to purchase homes. People are putting off starting companies, starting businesses, or you know, they're making choices about even getting married and starting a family. So, you know, what is happening right now with regards to college debt? It is a true crisis. And so we have to take some different action. And I'm thrilled to be able to, you know, share with your listeners a lot of different actions that people can take beyond pursuing the traditional scholarships and traditional financial aid avenues to help people really carve out their own path that does not have to be burdened by debt.
So if a family comes to you or a student, like, where do they start? Like, are they thinking about what's their options?
Sure. There are so many different options, and, you know, I want to, you know, give you a little bit of background about, you know, how I, expert, you know, in this area. You know, ultimately, I was doing some seminars across the country about 10, 15 years ago, helping students with success strategies while they're in college, you know, finding internships, you know, acing exams and time management tools. And when I was doing this, and I was meeting thousands of students and meeting hundreds of educators, I would hear over and over again how they needed to find ways to cut their college bills.
Yeah.
And, you know, cutting their college bills, you know, students were, there's a traditional way of students approaching, you know, college cost right now, you know, in this country. And that is students, you know, will rely on resources being given to them from their guidance counselors and their college offices. And based on those resources, they'll take advantage of opportunities maybe that are presented to them. And when the college or the university factors in what type of family contributions that that are estimated based on the income of a given family, then the student is faced with whatever monies they're going to be required to pay to that institution. And most students will just sign their name to student loans, realizing that they will pay off those student loans however long it takes once they're graduated from college. What families don't know is that if they take a proactive step towards looking at the cost of college, they can dramatically cut the cost of college by tens of thousands of dollars a year. And, you know, for some families, strategically, they can bring the bill down to zero. And I'll tell you, that is what I'm passionate about, because I would love to see more and more young people pursuing their dreams in college, carving out the life that they want for themselves that does not have to be burdened by debt.
But Jean, are you talking about, right, you have the student that's going to college next year, or what about speaking to families when the child is two? You know, is a lot of this planning before college?
So there's lots of things that students and families can do at any stage of the game. Some basic numbers, you know, across the board right now the cost per year of an average, you know, private college or university is, you know, $36,000. But you know, we know that's a given average. We have
schools. That's $36,000 per year or for the
per year. But there are, you know, given that that's an average, there are colleges and universities right now who have price tags of $65,000 or more per year. And so where a student ends up going to school is going to end up impacting that cost. You know, there are, you mentioned a family who, you know, is current, it maybe has a student who is heading off to college this year versus a family who maybe has a, you know, a young child, a two-year-old. So let's talk about both of those. A family that has a son or daughter who is, you know, planning on heading to college either this year or, you know, in the next couple years, there's a few things that family is able to definitely do and take a look at. First would be to take a look at what where that son or daughter is starting their education. At the end of the day, when someone is pursuing their professional field and they're interviewing, no one is ever going to ask, where did you start college? They want to know, where did you graduate from college? So a major cost savings for families is to start that college education at a community college, going to that community college for even a year can save tens of thousands of dollars. Right now, it's actually estimated that a family whose son or daughter starts a traditional four-year undergraduate education at a community college, so attending that community college for a couple of years and then transferring will save as much as $30,000. And that's some real money, Lorna.
Yeah, it is. You know, and that's smart. As you say, like when, you know, when you just said that there, I was like, oh, that's so true. People don't ask where you started college. They ask you where you graduate. Absolutely.
And you know, you also asked about, you know, planning in advance. You know, parents and or families who have younger children and planning in advance. I'll tell you, it surprises most families who I talk with that, you know, families can actually, students can actually start earning monies for college as young as 5 and 6 years old and in kindergarten. There's actually, you know, I'm an expert in outside scholarships. And outside scholarships are scholarships that are being given away from organizations, foundations, companies, individuals, and they are not connected to specific colleges and universities. What most families don't realize is that there are outside scholarships for very young individuals.
Okay. I've never heard of this. I live in Europe. What do you mean by outside scholarship? What is that?
So outside scholarships are scholarships that are not attached to a specific college or university. They are,
How do you go? So how do you go about this? So say I'm a 4-year-old, right? And I want to find out about an outside scholarship. I want to get them earning money. Is that what you said?
Sure. You can actually start accruing. You can, a student as young as 5, 6 years old and in kindergarten can already start accruing dollars, monies to pay for college. And I'll give you an example, a couple of examples of these and how the monies get awarded. So one example I always give to families, because regardless of where we are in the world, you mentioned that of course you're in Europe. There's an outside scholarship as one example that is given away from Google, right?
Okay.
Which is a company we're all familiar with. And yet most people do not realize that Google is among the many thousands of companies, organizations, foundations, individuals that offer an outside scholarship. Their outside scholarship, which is actually called, it's titled Doodle for Google, is open to students, kindergarten through 12th grade. There's no essay required. There's no GPA requirement. The only requirement for the Google scholarship is that they are a student going to school somewhere in the United States. And in that particular scholarship application, literally, they're awarding creativity. Whether that applicant is 6 years old or 16 years old, in that particular scholarship, that young person is literally going to just draw or doodle, right? Draw what they want to do when they grow up, what their dream is, and that happens to be the criteria for that specific scholarship. But Google gives away tens of thousands of dollars with that particular scholarship application. And
is this over time or in one lump sum?
No, so here's how outside, so especially for scholarships that are connected to, that are for younger students, right? A student that is not immediately graduating from high school, or a student who, you know, obviously is in elementary school, middle school. What happens is that scholarship will be awarded one of two ways. Either first, the scholarship committee cuts a check and is sent to that family, and that family will use that money either for educational expenses, such as educational camps or even private school, or put that money in their own, you know, savings account, or college savings account for when that student is ready to go off to college, more likely is that the other way that the money is awarded is that it's awarded in the form of a bond that will mature when that young person turns 18.
So
Google is one example. There's actually even there's a scholarship.
Is this a worldwide thing or is it just the U.S.?
Oh my gosh, there are so many scholarships that are frankly just for international students. Scholarships that are open to students regardless of where they live in the world. Wow. I wish that more families knew about this information. Right.
I agree. Only for you reached out to me, I was totally ignorant of this. I went to secondary school. There was a scholarship from the school, but other from that, I didn't know there was options or, you know, creative ways of, you know, like what you're sharing about Google. I mean, that's amazing. And you know, I've seen the Doodle Google thing, and you know, I didn't know this.
Yeah, it's really exciting to think and to realize that through outside scholarships and through other cost saving measures, which I definitely want to give your listeners, you know, some other cost saving strategies.
Yeah, let's talk about that. Sorry.
Stack the dollars. You can stack the dollars that you are. Making that pile of money that you can and should then put on top of, any college or university specific scholarships that, you know, get awarded, right? There's a lot of ways that people can save money, on the bill. And I want to quickly just give your, listeners, a few favorites that I have. And one for sure is a massive, massive cost savers. And it goes back to what we were just talking about a few minutes ago about planning in advance. This one this savings has to do with earning college credits in advance. Now, this does take a little bit of planning. It's not because it will require the family to start thinking about this and having conversations, you know, with their son or daughter. In their, ninth grade year, 10th grade year, in junior year of high school, and certainly their 12th grade year of high school as well. But the bill for your college degree is always going to be equivalent to how many credits you actually need to buy, right? How many classes you need to take in order to ultimately achieve that particular degree from that institution. So what if you were able to obtain some of those college credits for free or at a much reduced cost? And, you know, of course, you know, we talked a couple minutes ago about, you know, starting at a community college, and for some students, starting at that community college is going to, you know, say is definitely going to save some dollars, because the community college, price tag is much less than either a public school or a private school. But in high school, students, can and should be, this is a big strategic move. Can and should be taking as many as advanced placement, AP, advanced placement classes as they can, because how they test on the final exams for those AP courses, those advanced placement courses, they can also ultimately test out and receive college credits based on those scores. So think about this. If a student in high school is, let's say he or she is taking even, two or three advanced placement classes. And if they test highly on even just one of those AP exams, a typical family, will save, on average, anywhere between $1,000 to $1,500 just on that one class, that young person does not have to take in college because they tested strong enough in high school, with that exam. I met a student as I was touring a university actually here in the States, in New York, Adelphi University. And I met a young woman. She was a high school junior and she was touring the campus, and she had already, through advanced placement classes and also taking some summer courses at her local community college, which is another way to start earning college credits in advance, as an 11th grade high school student, she had already earned for herself 16 college credits. That young woman already is going to be able to start her first year at whatever college or university she goes to. She hadn't decided on whether she was going to go to Adelphi or not, but she's going to already be able to start with 16 college credits. That saves her already one term of college. So wow. Going back to this, the average amount of money at that private college institution being $36,000. I mean, you're looking at already a savings of $18,000. This is very real money that can be saved in advance with some proactive decision making.
Jean, we've had an amazing conversation. For anyone listening to this, I mean, I'm inspired for what you shared, that I didn't even know those options were out there. What would you say to a family listening to this and they're like, wow, I need to do something about this? What inspiration can you give them?
The very first step is to sit down as a family and talk about the real costs of college. Talk about what it would look like to carry a student debt after you've picked up your degree versus not having that debt. Because the motivation has to be real for that student who is making the choice to go on what I refer to as a money mission. They can go on this money mission to take actions for themselves now and set themselves up to pursue their dream without having that debt.
So Jean, thank you. Mm-hmm. How do we find out more about you?
So, definitely check out, we have tons of free resources at my website, connections101.com. And I post information about scholarship and ways to save money on college through my Facebook page and Instagram page, which is Scholarship Strategies. You can also reach out to me on Twitter at Scholarship Gene. But I'd also love to, extend a free gift to your listeners. If anyone posts a comment or a question at the Scholarship Strategies Facebook page or Instagram page or even our YouTube channel with the hashtag Financial Freedom Podcast, we will enter you in to win a copy of our book, Scholarship Strategies, Finding and Winning the Money You Need.
Thank you, Jean. This has been amazing. And, I've personally really enjoyed this. Now I'm going to look into options for my child.
Awesome. I love you. You know, it is exciting when a family gets started early. So I wish you and your family best of luck.
Thank you, Jane.
Thank you.
Hey, everyone. Remember to join us in the Private Financial Freedom Podcast Facebook group with me, your host, Lorna Poole. This is a safe haven of like-minded wealth-getting go-getters who, like you, are on their journey to creating financial freedom in their life. This is where you and I can get intimate. I can give you the support and guidance to go from where you are now to where you want to be, developing your wealth mindset and creating your financial freedom life. Join at www.facebook.com/groups/thefinancialfreedompodcast. You will see the links to this on the website. It's in the show notes, or type it into the Facebook group. All you have to type in is Financial Freedom Podcast and you will see us there. Look forward to seeing you in the group. Take care. Thank you for joining us on the Financial Freedom Podcast to creating wealth, investing, and developing your money mindset. To get started today on your journey, head on over to www.lornapoole.com and grab your free course, 5 Steps to Breaking Free from Your Poverty Mindset and Accelerating Your Journey to Financial Freedom. See you there.